Okay, tell me the top five boxers in the history of Liverpool, 1 through 5.
Johnny Quigley.
Okay. No, that's a James Tony answer.
From Liverpool.
John Conte.
John Conte.
Okay.
Is it?
Everybody named John?
Just, we've had a couple of world champions, and I can't even think of their names. There's Paul Hodgkinson or Ocho. He was a WBC champion.
I would think you would have much more. You know, it's known for being a blue-collar, hardcore town. And
yeah, it's a great city for boxing. It's one of the top cities in the country of boxing right now. They've got so many British champions. The Smith brothers, I don't know if you know the Smith brothers, four of them are champions.
Liverpool boxing at the moment is booming. There's so much talent in Liverpool, not just in the pros, but in the amateurs. It's booming. I'm just not very well educated on the history in the city, so.
And there was, remember Shane Eyre?
Oh, yeah.
He's the scouts, yeah, remember his fight where he won? He was good.
So there you have it. You're waiting for your first fight in America?
No, that was my third.
Your third?
My third fight, yeah. First fight, third win. I'm back in the gym on Monday, so. Back to work and looking forward to my next fight and improving my records and moving up to bigger things.
And Jay, if you can compare your style to any star from the past, who do you compare yourself to?
I've had comparisons to Prince Nazeem, Pinnell Whittaker, Roy Jones Jr. Like the names who I get compared to, like crazy.
He told me that you're like Prince Nazeem. Why did you say he's like Prince? He looks nothing like him. No, he said you move like him.
He's got the awkwardness, I mean his style, like his instincts and his reflexes. I mean, I've only seen a couple guys really be able to pull it off. Like, yeah, Junior Witter and those guys, they were awkward, but they didn't have the instincts and reflexes that he has. I mean, it comes natural. The Prince was like that. The only thing that he's lacking that the Prince had is punching power. I think once he really develops and learns and sits and turns and twists and really shifts the weight properly, I think we'll see a lot of punches and a lot of knockouts out of him.
There's a lot of work still to be done.
There's a lot of
room. Yeah. Always in the gym looking to improve. That's what I want to keep working on my strength, my speed. I'm just working on my overall game. So just improve, get better.
That's it. Just keep working hard and.
That's it. As long as I'm 100% dedicated and I'm training hard, the results will come and the performances will come.
By the way, have you heard of this new guy from Yemen? He's 22-0 with 21 knockouts. Last name is Ali. Yeah, he fights at 100 pounds though.
You serious?
Yeah, 100 pounds. And he's knocked out. He fights in Yemen, and he's knocked out everyone he's ever fought.
What's his name?
I forgot his first name. Last name Ali.
Yemen boxer named Ali.
What weight is 100 pounds?
Huh?
What weight is 100 pounds? Strawweight.
Can you go down? Can you lose like 30 pounds?
I could now, but not so 100.
So there you have it. Stay tuned. We'll follow you on Twitter once again. What's your Twitter?
At Johnny Craig.
Oh, my boy won tonight too.
Congratulations.
No, Roberto Garcia from the gym.
Oh, he won last night.
He won last night on ESPN.
He's 34-3 now.
34-3, yeah. It was a good win for me.
There you have it. Rashad Holloway right here. BoxingBrokerTheEsNews.com. I'm going to say back to 40.